The square root example has to do with specifying the properties of the results of the computation of a function. We might also consider situations where the effect of a particular operation is to change the attribute values for some class. How might we do that? Well, let's consider the example of a bank account and has an attribute which is the current balance and has operations for deposits and withdrawals. We might wish to guarantee that the current balance reflects any deposits that are made and any withdrawals that are taken out. How might we express such a constraint? Well, here's an example. If we have a deposit operation in the account class that takes a real argument, which is the amount being deposited, and as a sanity check, we make sure that that amount is greater than zero. That's the precondition. We might try to express the postcondition with something like saying the balance equals balance plus the amount. However, remember that OCL is a declarative language, and equal sign here means equality. It doesn't mean assignment. So what we're saying with this as the way that it's written is the balance equals the balance plus the amount. Well, that can't be the case, right? That doesn't make sense. Fortunately, OCL has a mechanism for allowing us to express these sorts of situations where we're changing values. And that particular mechanism consists of an at sign followed by the word pre. And what that denotes is the value before the operation executed. If we don't use at pre, then what we're seeing when we express balance or deposit or anything like that is the value afterwards. So we can express the post condition this time correctly by saying that balance equals balance at pre plus amount. That is, we take the previous balance, add in the amount being deposited, and we get the new balance. Looks like an assignment statement, but it's really an equality.